What's going on, guys? Chris Kennedy here. Today, I'm going to talk the North Carolina Tar Heels. We're going to talk the team, the schedule, and I'm going to give you my prediction on how I think things are going to play out for them in 2021. And is this a team that is ever so slightly closing the gap between themselves and Clemson? Is there finally another team in the ACC that can make that conference a little bit more competitive? We'll talk about that as well too. But before we get into it, first things first, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already. I love talking college football. It's fun to do. I'm no expert, but the fun part is engaging with you guys in the comments because you bring up great points, and a lot of times they're points that I haven't considered for myself. So it helps me shape my point of view on things. Keep that information coming, and I appreciate it. Now, 2020, this North Carolina team, offensively, very explosive. One of the best offenses in the country. Sam Howell, your quarterback, he's returning. 30 touchdowns, 7 interceptions, over 3,500 yards passing, 68% passing completion percentage. So him coming back is definitely a huge, huge piece to what I think this team can do next year. And he's a guy that's already in Heisman talk. So how's he going to handle that pressure? Mac said that they had to talk to him about that. And he said that Sam said it's going to be fine. No problems there. Now, you got to replace your running backs, Michael Carter and Javonte Williams. Both guys off to the NFL. Had over 1,000 yards rushing last year. And 25 catches apiece out of the backfield. So guys that North Carolina depended on in that passing game, who's going to be able to fill that role? You got Ty Chandler coming in for the transfer portal. Max said, no doubt, he's going to be one of the guys. But there's not a lot of separation between the other running backs. Those backs being British Brooks, Josh Henderson, Elijah Green, DJ Jones, Kamaru Edmonds is coming in from high school. Caleb Hood is a guy who's transitioning from quarterback to running back. Who's going to be the other running back to line up next to Ty Chandler? Your receivers, you lose Deami Brown and Daz Newsome to the NFL, but I'm not really worried about receivers. I think Choffrey Brown showed that he's somebody you can depend on. Bo Corrales is back from his injury, and he had a good year in 2019. Antoine Green, Emory Simmons, and then Josh Downs is a receiver that Max said had a better spring compared to any of the guys out there. So what can he do, and is he going to be maybe that number three receiver out there? We'll see how it goes. Now, you got your tight end returning as well, Garrett Walston. He was a part of the offense. But the strength of this team, I think, is the offensive line besides the quarterback. I mean, you have to have your quarterback situation solved, and they do. But the offensive line, 4 of the 5 returning starters were all ACC honorable mention guys. Josh Azudu, Brian Anderson, Marcus McKeithen, and Jordan Tucker all coming back. Asim Richards was another starter. I think he started 11 to 12 games last year. So, man, the continuity right there is huge. And Mack Brown has said, look, that's not what we're really focused on. I mean, yes, development is huge, but we need to develop depth. That's been the focus. And that's really what's been holding North Carolina back, in my opinion, from maybe taking that next step forward. But offensively, this team, in my opinion, should be humming along just fine. I think Phil Longo is one of the best offensive coordinators in the game, even dating back to his time at Ole Miss, always had offenses that put out a lot of yards. So we'll see what they can do in 2021. Now, people are excited about this team because of what they're doing defensively. Now, you lose Chaz Surratt, and he's a big loss. There's no question about it. But Tamon Fox is back for your linebacker core. Tyrone Hopper, Jeremiah Gimmel, Eugene Asante. Gimmel, 78 tackles. Tamon Fox, 36 tackles, 7 sacks. So you have your linebacking core, in my opinion, solved. Your defensive front, Tamari Fox returns, 46 tackles, 4 sacks. Raymond Vahosik, the nose tackle, he's back as well. 29 tackles, 3.5 sacks. And then you got other guys, Kevin Hester, Jaleel Taylor, Miles Murphy. How do they fit in? The reason people are excited is because 10 of 11 starters return. People expect them to be better. And this was a defense that ranked middle of the pack as far as things go. 50th in pass defense, rush defense, total defense. They should be a better team. Now your cornerbacks, Tony Grimes, Kyler McMichael, Jaquarius Conley, your nickel back. I think he's actually going from nickel to strong safety. flipping spots with Don Chapman, or at least that's what North Carolina has been experimenting with. Both those guys, big-time contributors. Don Chapman, 48 tackles. Then you got Trey Morrison, your other safety. He was an all-ACC guy, 39 tackles, a sack, a pick, couple of pass deflections. So we'll see what he can do. And then you got Cameron Kelly as well out there, a guy that had 55 tackles and 3 pass deflections. So it'll be interesting to see what they do, but I think the depth on the defensive side of the ball is what is going to make this team even better than what they were last year. And Mac has already said, hey, we wanted to force more turnovers in the spring, and we felt we've done that compared to the way we've done things in years past. And just overall communication in our secondary is a lot better. That's a good sign. Now, looking at the schedule for North Carolina, you open up against Virginia Tech in Blacksburg. That's going to be a tough game, week one. That'll be a challenge, and that will... It's not going to be an easy test, in my opinion. It's a game that you should win. I think you're more talented than Virginia Tech, but playing in Blacksburg on the road week one, not an easy task. Then you get Georgia State, and then you got Virginia after that. Then you're on the road at Georgia Tech. You should be favored in that game, no problems. Then you get Duke, and then you play Florida State. And Florida State is a team that got by you last year. I don't know how they did, because you were more talented than them, but... this is a team that I think will be better this year, in my opinion. I made a video on them. I think they're going to be the most improved team in the ACC, but you should still win that game. And then you get the game, in my opinion, that will decide who goes and plays Clemson in the ACC championship, and that's against the Miami Hurricanes. Now, you get them at home, and that's a good thing, and you guys absolutely routed Miami last year. But Miami is going to be a good team, too. And this is probably the one team inside the ACC, or the one game inside the ACC, rather, that I'm looking forward to more than any other game. I think it's going to be great. I think it's going to be close. I don't think North Carolina is going to blow Miami out this year. I could be wrong, but this is tough. And this will, in my opinion, decide all. This is for all the marbles. Now, then you get a bye, and then you're at Notre Dame. I think you're going to beat Notre Dame. I think you're a better team than Notre Dame. Notre Dame loses a lot, but it all depends on how things go against Miami. I mean, this is a tough two-game stretch playing the Cam. Actually, a tough three-game stretch playing Florida State, Miami, and then Notre Dame. But I like North Carolina in this game, just more talented. Then you get Wake Forest, and then you're at Pitt, a Thursday night game, and Pitt is not a team to sleep on. For some reason, man, Pitt has ruined some team seasons before, or pulled some upsets and won games that they shouldn't have won. This is a game that I think you got to be careful about, because those Thursday night games are tricky. Then you get Wofford, and then you play North Carolina State, a North Carolina State last year that was pretty good. Rivalry game, so we'll see how that plays out. But when I look at this schedule for North Carolina, I like them to go 11-1 on the season. Now, I made a video about Miami, and I also predicted Miami to have a really good year as well. Check it out. I think this ACC conference is just getting better. I think this year overall in football, you're going to have a really good year. There's some reasons behind that, but man, this North Carolina team, you should be excited about them. They should be good. Now, Mack Brown, wanted to talk a little bit about it. I mean, this is a really good story, because Mack Brown, it didn't end well at Texas. He was out for a long time. And when he took the job in North Carolina, he said, I feel that I'm a better coach because I've been able to cover all these games in ESPN. I've been to practices. I've just now got a broader view on what's going on in college football. And at the time, I kind of shook it off to, yeah, whatever. I mean, he's just saying it. But, you know, after what he's done the last couple of years and the direction that he has North Carolina going, I mean, I can't help but think, man, maybe brought up a good point. Now, it doesn't work out for everybody, but it's working for Mac, and so far, so good. He's got a staff of guys who are great recruiters. Now, you got to replace Robert Gillespie, but bringing in a guy like Larry Portal, a three-time Broyles Award nominee coming in from Auburn, I think maybe, you know, you can fill those holes that you have losing Robert Gillespie. The key is getting the players to compete with these big time teams. He recognizes that, and he brought in great recruiters. Dre Bly, a good recruiter on his side of the ball. Tommy Thigpen, recognized as a really good recruiter as well. So you have a good staff that can make you competitive, and they're just getting better year after year. People think that this year might be the year that North Carolina puts it all together. But you guys let me know in the comments what you think. Do you think North Carolina is going to be a good team? Do you think they're going to be the team that you can just pencil in right now to go to the ACC championship game and play Clemson? And even more so, do you think they could possibly upset Clemson? That might be a bold statement, but let me know in the comments what you think. I appreciate you guys listening to the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll talk to you again later.